We got some hounds that are.
I'd ask you guys to leave the property right now.
Put up an 8-foot fence and keep everybody out.
Okay, baby.
So you were out doing chores around your farm the other day.
Hey, can I help you?
This is who I am and what I'm about. We got some hounds that are.
I'd ask you guys to leave the property right now.
Leave
the property right now, please.
Okay.
All right. Explain. Go for it, Butch. Because I know it's not an accident you're here either.
No, my dogs brought this bear from the cornfield here over through to Great Road, over through to almost North County Road. It turned, went behind the alfalfa.
Yeah, so I actually don't want you guys on my property.
All right. So would it be sensible enough to say we can go in and get our dogs and get the hell out of there?
Go in and get your dogs. Can I come with you?
You can go with us. Not a
problem. All right. Hang on a sec.
It's your land.
So you might be thinking that I was being a little bit harsh on this Santa Claus-looking grandpa guy. But I feel like I had some good reason.
Do you call the cops?
You see,
call the cops.
Over the last few weeks, I've been having my fair share of run-ins with hound hunters coming onto our property. It all started when some raccoon hunters showed up on our farm in the middle of the night, and we had an altercation. Yelling happened, the cops were called, and it was kind of a big mess. And ever since that incident, I became pretty engaged in looking at hound hunting laws in the state of Vermont, seeing what I could do to keep our farm safe and our animals protected, and ensure that the wildlife isn't being harassed. As I was doing my research, I came across a guy by the name of Butch Spear. Butch was that grandpa-looking gentleman that you just saw. So I knew who he was, and now here he was, on my land, with his hunting dogs, and an innocent bear trapped in a tree. The irony of this situation was absolutely not lost on me. I must go, I know I'm a good run.
You guys have permission to retrieve your dogs, but you're not no hunting, and then ask you never to return.
All right, and I appreciate what you're saying.
Yeah.
But again, if we release my dogs 6-7 miles from here, and they end up, the bear runs this way, they're doing what they're taught to do. And they tree again, just like they did right now.
Yeah.
So
that's saying you have no control to respect my rights as a private property owner.
Oh, I respect it.
No, but you have no control over your dogs. That's my point. See, here's the thing. So as a private property owner, right?
Yeah.
I should be able to say, hey, I don't want somebody on my property hunting.
Yeah.
Is that fair? Do you believe that?
Right now, I'm not hunting. I'm a retriever.
No.
I'm a retriever.
No. Semantics aside, I don't want somebody hounding on my land. How about that? Let's say that.
I understand that.
So as a private property owner, shouldn't I have the ability to do that?
Yes and no. What I usually tell people that are dead fast against people being on there, put up an 8-foot fence and keep everybody out.
Dude, I got 160 acres. That's not practical. It's not practical for wildlife. I don't want to have to prevent wildlife from passing through.
And it's not practical or sensible for me to pay for a hunting license in the state of Vermont, abide by all their laws, and then not be able to hunt for 20 miles from here because a bear runs this way.
You got to just, it's like out of bounds. It's out of bounds.
You tell me how.
Ollie oxen free, man. Out of bounds.
As soon we were driving around here to try to get in front of our dogs.
Yeah.
They're in the woods. We got in front as fast as we could, but they stopped right there.
So, but your point, I just want to make sure I'm very clearly hearing your point. Your point is you can't control where your dogs go if they're tracking something.
I can't control the bear. The dogs are taught to follow the bear.
Right, but if you can't control the bear, then you can't control your dogs if the dogs are controlled by the bear.
By state law, I am 100% in control of my dogs right now.
All right, well, let's go get your dog.
We got 452 yards to go.
Let's go get it.
Yeah. You track better than I do, Jason, so you go ahead. This is my son, Jason. That's his son.
How's it going, guys? I'm Morgan. Nice to meet you.
I'm Harold.
Harold, nice
Harold's
to meet you.
Harold's a neighbor of mine. We're a good friend.
Where are you guys from?
right there.
Newberry.
Two of us are right there from that cart, and the other two are from New York, but they're my family. Feather in my cap, sir. It would have been shorter from that road that goes out through there.
Yeah.
And I could have snuck in without you knowing.
I appreciate that. I will absolutely do that. Yep. The folks who actually I caught the other week, they just wandered on in the middle of the night without any notice, 11:30, chasing dogs, running through my farm, scaring my birds. I have free range geese just about 100 yards, 150 yards that way.
Yep. They were coon hunters.
Yep. And I'll also tell you, man, I'm not opposed to hunting. It's hounding, really.
But people have been using hounds since before the Romans.
I appreciate that. People had slaves back when they were Romans. Doesn't mean you should be having slavery either, right?
Sometimes I wish we did.
What?
Sometimes I wish we did.
Wait, what? Wait, what? Did you just say you wish we had slavery?
I'm old enough now so that I wish somebody would do my work for me. I believe in people have rights, but I also understand people need to understand other people's rights. Also, it's not always a one-way street.
100% agree. But you should also be free saying, hey, I want to have my farm here. I want to make sure my livestock guardian dog isn't getting harassed by hounds. I want to make sure I don't have strangers just wandering up trying to get on my property to say, hey, you know what? Respect the property line, man.
Yep, I do. That's why I came to your door to talk to you.
As I talked more and more with Butch, I kind of realized there was this fundamental disconnect. He was a guy who believed he had a right to pursue his hounds wherever they may go. And I was a guy who believed that I had the right to protect my property border, however it may be. Those two rights are in direct conflict in this debate that I think we're having here. You know, ever since I came out with my first video about the issues we've had with hound hunters, a lot of folks have called me a Karen. A lot of folks called me a textbook case of a city guy trying to make the country life conform to his beliefs. And a lot of folks said that I was a typical example of a liberal. But the odd thing to me is, I feel like the core of my argument here is not so much a liberal point of view as it is a libertarian point of view. I genuinely feel like a guy who's just simply trying to say, I don't want hunting happening on my land. I don't want people chasing down bears on my land. I don't want strangers on my land.
How far away would you say they are right now? See, part of my qualm too is, if you're doing this the old-fashioned way, right, just you and a couple of dogs, I can respect it. When you have the tracker and you're a couple miles away from where you set loose your dogs, you're not actually in control of your animal.
According to state law, we are.
So you would say that it's really, to make an impact on that, you have to change the state law.
Definitely. I help make them laws.
I know, I read up on you, man.
That are in effect.
Did you
right
see
now.
My petition yet?
What's that?
Did you see my petition yet? It's kind of ironic that you happen to be here today.
No, I haven't seen. I don't go on Facebook or anything. I'm a dinosaur.
So, ever since some yahoos came on here a couple weeks ago, coon hunting in the middle of the night,
yeah.
I've been actually making videos on this topic. Yeah. I have a YouTube channel.
Well, I don't mind that a bit, as long as it's 100% the truth.
I trade in the truth, man.
I know people that are in POW, check their wildlife. Brenna can turn every truth into a lie and put it in the paper and get away with it.
Well, man, to be honest, you were actually on my list of people I wanted to reach out to. You and Commissioner Porter, actually asking about this very topic. So like I said, it's quite fortuitous that you showed up today.
Yep. I believe there's a reason for everything.
I actually do like want to hear your side of the story a little bit more, too.
I'll be glad to sit right down and talk with you anytime you want.
All right, man.
About the whole thing.
I will 100% take you up on that.
But I will say right up front, it will be a peaceful, non-yelling, non-swearing conversation or it won't happen.
100%. I'm good. And don't apologize if my excited way of talking comes off as yelling. It's not intended.
If I was offended, you would have heard it.
All right, fair enough, man.
As we got closer, the sounds of the hounds became deafening. There was a fury and a frenzy in their howls. They clearly had an animal up in the tree, and they would stop at absolutely nothing to get it. Going out into the woods with Butch and his crew gave me an appreciation for why somebody might like this sport. But my feeling about not wanting to have to participate in this sport still stood. I understand that they have a right to do this, but I'm still struggling to see why I don't have a right to opt out of this. Based on everything Butch told me, that's how hound hunting works. As we got there, the four gentlemen took the time to get their dogs under control, and I was struck by the sight of that bear in the tree. Such a beautiful and majestic creature, the animal that's actually in the logo of our farm, up in that tree, terrified for its life. It was something that I absolutely don't want to see happening on my farm. I feel like if I want to make my farmland a refuge for animals, I should be able to and not have folks chase and pursue those animals. As the bear scurried down the tree, it made its way off to safety, and true to their words, the hound hunters did not pursue. But I must say, this type of disruption, based on what everything Butch was telling me, is inevitable when you have hound hunting. And for me as a landowner to prevent it, there's virtually nothing short of erecting a fence around my entire property that I can do. But by erecting that fence, I'm not able to witness majestic wildlife like that bear. And that, to me, is very, very sad.
Well, that's what we have to put up with to enjoy something that's been going on in my family for 4 or 5 generations.
Yeah, but here's my point, Butch. The tools and equipment you're using and the way you're doing it now and the landscape in which you're doing it in has radically changed even in the last 15 years. And so sometimes things need to change and evolve. The hunting regulations around this have not materially changed since the advent of some of the GPS stuff. It's true.
A little bit.
Wait, are you saying it's not true? I mean, like, if I got my facts twisted, by all means, I want to be speaking truth, like to what we said earlier.
This machine right here in my hand is so I can find out where my dogs are absolute instead of me driving around this.
Yeah, but how far away are you going?
Instead of driving around this 10, 12, 15 times a day,
right.
I can say, hey, they're treed.
Right.
Let's go.
How many miles away have you been today? 2?
From her?
From her? Great run. All right, so at least a mile.
Yeah.
So you're more than a mile away from your animal. Yeah. That's not having control of an animal. No, I'm serious. Like, look, my dog is an exceptionally well-trained, obedient dog.
Yeah.
If I had him 400 yards away, I couldn't get him to do what I wanted. If I had him 400 feet away, I probably couldn't get him to do exactly what I wanted. So maybe he's not as well-trained as your dogs, but you can't even call your dog at a mile away.
Oh, yeah.
Like, just watching how those dogs were in a frenzy with that bear in a tree.
When they're on a bear, no, I cannot.
Yeah, but that's my point. So you don't have control. You're a mile away.
Yeah.
Your dog's tree a bear.
Yep.
You got some misguided hikers, out-of-state folks, don't know what they're doing. Let me protect this bear. These dogs are going crazy. Let me get in front of...
Why would they do that?
Because they want to protect the bear.
they want to get hurt by a wild animal.
They're just seeing these dogs as the much more of the threat. I looked at that bear up in the tree. He's like, help me. I get that that might be a misguided view, but my point is recognize that not everybody has your experience and perspective.
Anybody that knows anything about dogs, you walk up on a dog, you don't put your hand right out and yell at them and holler and tell them to stop because they're not your dog.
I would agree with that.
Regardless of whether it's a poodle or one of these hounds.
Look, man, I've got a livestock guardian dog. Lives outdoors 24/7. I have people who come visit the farm. First thing they want to do, stick their hand through the fence. Yeah. So I feel your pain on people not understanding. But I take my responsibility that I have to prevent them from being able to even do that.
Yeah.
See, that's the thing.
Then
that's where I'm taking responsibility of it. That's where I don't feel like you guys are necessarily acting as responsible as you could. Look, you're acting way more responsible than the dudes that showed up the other night. So I give you that 100%, no doubt. The problem is, I still think there's some ways to go.
Well, there is. But until the laws are changed, we're doing everything legal.
So would you advocate working to change the laws to address some of my concerns?
I would sit down with people who wanted to change the laws, and I would tell them my view, and it would go to a democratic situation where majority rules and be voted on. And you can write this down, you can print it anywhere. The day I lose my rights to run hounds is the day I start advocating getting rid of mountain bikes, getting rid of canoes and kayaks that are not registered to be on the water, get rid of bicycles going down tar roads that create accidents. And I will dream up 1,000 other things that the people that took my rights away, they will lose their rights. And that's a promise. It doesn't do good to fight and argue.
I'm with you there.
It does wonders to discuss and try to make a mediocre thing.
I'm 100% with you there.
But as far as me giving up the right to hunt and hounds, it ain't gonna happen.
The biggest thing I'm keying in on, man, just even from this conversation, is it's not so much your right to hunt and hound, it's how far can you be from your dogs?
How fast can you run?
Oh, me? I'm a big fat boy who's slow, so maybe 7 miles an hour, 8 miles an hour?
I'm 69 years old.
Yeah.
I've got lung problems. I have trouble walking with a dog.
Right.
They tried 3 years ago, they tried to make it so the dogs had to be on a leash at all times. What's the sense of having a dog to go hunting?
I also recognize, though, it should be my personal right to say, hey, look, if I don't want hounds running through here in the middle of the day while I'm trying to build a new coop, or if I'm like in sleeping in the middle of the night and they're coon hounding in here, like I feel like I should have that right too, but I don't feel like the way hound hunting happens right now is what happens that way.
It used to be worse. We're talking.
We're talking. We are talking.
We made a first step. That goes back to us sitting down and having a
peaceful. All right. We're going to do that. I really want to take you up on that, man.
And, you know, you bring somebody that has some authority in so that they can say. Well,
so wait, if I were to get a conversation for you, me, and Commissioner Porter, would you be up for that?
I'd love it.
Okay.
I'd love it.
And what about someone like Brenna, too, in the mix?
Brenna?
Because I feel like I actually don't come from the same point of view she does.
I would love to be able to sit down with Brenna, but she will not do it. And I offered to buy the coffee. I offered to meet her in public.
Thanks, guys. But yeah, I'd ask you to avoid coming to our farm again.
We'll
set up some time.
We'll do the best we can to stay away.
All right.
I mean, but I'm not going to start hunting in Berlin to avoid possibly ending up here. This is the first time I've been on your property.
Really? I got to say, the coincidence and timing of that is absolutely incredible.
And I've been hunting bears 18 years.
All right, guys.
Thank you, sir.
All right, thanks a lot. Have a good day, guys.
So I'm really glad that I went with Butch and his crew out to go see the hounds and the bear and free the bear. I found our conversation to be a very interesting one. On one hand, I still absolutely do not want folks hunting bears and coons with hounds. on our farm. On the other hand, I understand where folks like Butch are coming from, where they have this hobby or sport that they've been doing for years and years and years and has been a tradition passed along by their family. And to have some dude like me coming in saying that it should be banned probably isn't the right thing either. As I think about where does all this go and what happens next, I don't know. Number one, I still think hounds need to respect property boundaries and hound hunters need to find a way to ensure that their animals don't end up here on our farm. I think the way I'm going with this one is I'm going to continue to listen and learn. I'm still holding my perspective pretty strongly here, but seeing the other world from other points of view is something I should probably push myself to do a bit more. And yeah, I'm definitely going to take Butch up on his offer for another conversation, and so who knows, maybe you'll see that here, maybe you won't. Let's see where this one goes. I'm really curious to get your perspective and see what you all think about this one, so let me know down in the comments, and I'll be back again soon with another video. Thanks for watching, guys.